In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who by the glorification of your Christ and the light of the Holy Spirit have unlocked for us the gates of eternity, grant, we pray, that partaking of so great a gift, our devotion may grow deeper and our faith be strengthened. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. King Agrippa and Bernice arrived in Caesarea on a visit to Festus. Since they spent several days there, Festus referred Paul's case to the king, saying, "There is a man here left in custody by Felix. When I was in Jerusalem, the chief priests and the elders of the Jews brought charges against him and demanded his condemnation. I answered them that it was not Roman practice to hand over an accused person before he has faced his accusers and had the opportunity to defend himself against their charge. So when they came together here, I made no delay. The next day, I took my seat on the tribunal and ordered the man to be brought in. His accusers stood around him, but did not charge him with any of the crimes I suspected. Instead, they had some issues with him about their own religion and about a certain Jesus who had died, but who Paul claimed was alive. Since I was at a loss how to investigate this controversy, I asked if he were willing to go to Jerusalem and there stand trial on these charges. And when Paul appealed that he be held in custody for the emperor's decision, I ordered him held until I could send him to Caesar." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits.
The Lord has established His throne in heaven.
For us the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is His kindness toward those who fear Him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has He put our transgressions from us.
The Lord has established His throne in heaven.
The Lord has established His throne in heaven, and His kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you His angels, you mighty in strength, who do His bidding.
The Lord has established His throne in heaven. Please stand.
The Holy Spirit will teach you everything and remind you of all I told you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus had revealed Himself to His disciples and eaten breakfast with them, He said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." He then said to Simon Peter a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." He said to him, "Tend my sheep." He said to him the third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was distressed that he had said to him a third time, "Do you love me?" And he said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep. Amen, amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go." He said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. And when he had said this, he said to him, "Follow me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Jesus gave Peter powerful words how his life will be. "When you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go wherever you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go." Hindi po ba kapag ka mas lumalaki o nagiging masagana ang karanasan sa buhay at marahil sa edad po natin, the more we can control and even direct our life. Dahil alam na natin eh, naranasan ko na to, baka dito ko papunta. But it seems different from the Lord. As life goes on, as we age, as we learn from this world, the more we are led to withdraw our hands from controlling too much to trusting God so much. Ano po ang ibig kong sabihin batay sa mga sinabi ni Jesus kay San Pedro? Parte ng pagtanda ang sanang malakas na pagtitiwala. It is sometimes the regret of people that they have controlled life too much, that God can't even do His part anymore. But we are reminded of the words of Jesus to Peter. Dadating ang panahon, itataas mo na lamang ang kamay mo at iba ang magbibihis na sa'yo at dadalin ka sa mga lugar na hindi mo nais. But Jesus said this to signify what kind of death He would face. But let us not forget the succeeding line, the kind of death that He would glorify God. Too much holding to or control may not give God the glory, but may lead to too much self-glorification. Yung manaig ang sarili at hindi na tayo makapagbigay puri sa Diyos o harapin yung kabutihan ng Diyos. It is our lesson and our prayer that may we withdraw our hands from controlling too much to trusting God so much. Baka kung tayo na lang ang magdidesisyon, tayo na lang ang kikilos, ang gagawa ng mga pamamaraan sa buhay, at hindi na magtitiwala o marahil itataas ang kamay at magpapagabay, baka hindi na po natin pinupurihan at minamahal ang Diyos. But if we will trust God, if we will trust the hands of God so much, we know that there will be grace, there will be peace, there will be that confidence in our lives. My dear brothers and sisters, we won't be led to nowhere when we trust God so much. We might lose when we trust ourselves too much. And like Peter, we stretch out our hands, be led by the Lord, trust the Lord, and glorify God to where He wants us to be, to where He wants us to be fruitful.
Please stand.
Let us pray the Oratio Imperata ad Petendam Pluviam. Together, God, our loving Father,
Creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures, so that your people can engage in productive undertakings, and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God,
open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation, and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise towards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look mercifully, O Lord, we pray, upon the sacrificial gifts of your people, and that they may become acceptable to you. Let the coming of the Holy Spirit cleanse our consciences. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, He ascended not to distance Himself from our lowly state, but that we, His members, might be confident of following where He, our Head and Founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Afraid, I'm beyond all.
Please stand.
Let us pray. O God, by whose mysteries we are cleansed and nourished, grant, we pray, that this banquet which you give us may bring everlasting life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.